Guys, welcome to my channel. Today we will talk about the Jesus Christ we are the worship for Africa, and the one we are the worship. Well, it is different from the one we are the worship in the sense that the picture we are the see, we are the use. That picture we are the say like Jesus, not be Jesus Christ too. I want make you know that one for sure. Now let's talk. You see, are they for market where they sell all this? Okay, what thing I go do? You say. Let me change. Saying this is it. Did you know that Jesus made about 3 or 4 miracles that is not in your Bible? Did you know that?
Yeah.
You don't know. Now I will tell you that Jesus made some miracle that is not included in the Bible that you guys are reading. Number one, the first miracle that Jesus did was on Shabbat day. On Shabbat day, Jesus was playing as a small child. He was still a small boy of about 7 years old or thereabout. And he was playing with clay on Shabbat day, and on that Shabbat day, you know, in Israel on Shabbat day, you don't have to touch anything, even your fan in your house or TV, you can't on it, which is Shabbat day, which is Saturdays, you understand? So on that Shabbat day, you must not play with anything. So Jesus was playing with the little children on Shabbat day with clay. He was using the clay to mold many things, you know. So this rabbi now came to Jesus. I want you to be seeing my environment, so that is why I'm talking here now. So what happened like that? Like the rabbis came to Jesus, went to Joseph, his father, and said, "Look at your son. Today is Shabbat day. He's there playing with clay. Go and warn your son." So they were like shouting on him. Do you know what he did? He threw the clay up. And hey, how are you?
Amazing.
Yeah. What's your name?
Benny.
Yeah, my name is Solomon.
Solomon.
Yeah, I'm from Africa.
Where from Africa?
I'm from Nigeria.
Nigeria is a big country.
Yeah, it's a big country and rich country.
A lot of
Israelis.
They are making money.
Yeah. But I'm here making peanuts.
You
go to Africa now, you make too much money.
Yeah?
If you go to Africa now, you're gonna make too much money.
No, we're gonna be there like after 2 days. It's like, depends.
It's a connection. It's a connection. Yeah. You understand? If you know an Israeli that is in Nigeria, he will bring you for business.
The building, all the road.
Yeah, the road, the construction.
Good connection with the government.
Yeah. How are you doing?
Amazing.
Yeah, I'm just vlogging around. I have a YouTube channel. I'm telling the people about Israel. It's nice, you know.
It's
amazing country. When they are there in Africa or other countries, they think all of us are dying here. You understand?
Yeah.
But we are not dying. Israel is number one. They are strong.
Life is hard, but it's good.
Yeah, thank you, my brother.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. So, Jesus threw the clay up and it turned to pigeon. He turned to bed, the pigeon. That was the first miracle that Jesus did. You want to hear another one? Another miracle that Jesus did was when he was a child, he was playing with a fellow child. You know that kind of thing where we say, Pikin go climb on top of something and then they play together. And that child fell down from that stairs and died. So when he died, the people gathered and said, "Oh, Joseph." Actually, it was Mary that was around. Like, "Oh, look at your son. He killed our son. He pushed him down from the stairs." And what happened? Jesus was like, "Oh, it is not me. I'm not the one who did this. It's not me. He fell down by himself." You know, on the point of argument, the Jesus was trying to explain himself that I'm not the one who did this. Honestly, I'm not the one who did it. He fell by himself. But nobody believed him. They say he pushed him down. And let me tell you one thing you don't know. Jesus was not too quiet at his childhood. You know, small children, they are arrogant, actually. So they believe he was the one who did it. Not disrespectful. I'm not saying that kind of disrespect. You know, children, when they play. When I say arrogant, it's not like a child who is abusing elders. So I want you guys to understand me. And hello. So at this point, make una know say here too that they sew clothes. They get tailors where they sew clothes. But because I'm talking now, I think I should wait here and finish my talk so that I'll be able to vlog so that when I go to see their tailor shops. You know, all these clothes they come from China and they get tailored. They get some professional tailor, what we say. They buy and sew. So as I was saying, Jesus now tell them that no, I am not the one who pushed this guy down. He fell by himself. You know what happened? As everybody don't gather for village, Jesus went to that guy and touched him. He wake up. That was the second miracle of Jesus Christ. If you know, you know. You want to know the third miracle of Jesus? When he was still a child, remember Joseph was a carpenter. Joseph was fixing someone's Jesus was fixing somebody's table, and he mistakenly cut the wood. So the wood was not enough anymore, and the man was like shouting on Joseph, like, "What is happening now? You spoil my wood." You know that kind of a thing, that if he mistakenly spoiled his maybe in a table or whatever it was. Now, this is what Jesus did. Oh, it's nice. The emergency. So, as I was saying, Jesus did what? He went to that wood and hold it and expand the wood by miracle, and the wood came back to normal the way it's supposed to be. If you know, you know. And here's another thing I want to talk about. Before I talk the last one about Jesus, let me talk. If you are a Muslim, let me tell you one thing, because our religion, we too they carry on too much for Africa. You see, when I was in Nigeria, when you tell somebody Salam Alaikum as a Muslim, and you are not a Muslim, the Muslim will not answer you. If he ever want to answer you, he will not answer you if he will say Ma Alaikum. You see, that language is not a religion. It's just a language. Let me tell you, if you are a Muslim today, I want you to get this, that when you tell somebody Salam Alaikum, it's just a language of greeting. Here, when you go a Muslim in this country, when you greet a Muslim in this country, Salam Alaikum, he will greet you. You see, the Christians that are Arab, when you greet them, Salam Alaikum. And this hijab that you guys normally wear, you think it's a religion. It's not a religion wear. It's just a traditional wear of the Middle East. Now, traditional wear, it's a traditional wear. A Muslim who wear that is not a religion to them. It's just a tradition. The Muslim and the Christian wear the same. If you go to Bethlehem or right here in Yafo, that they are Catholic, they want to cover themselves. That is their religion. It's Middle East. It's always hot here. So that's another one. The dress, the way you dress as a Muslim, it's not your religion. It's just their tradition. When you say, tell somebody Salam Alaikum, it's the ordinary greeting. If you go to Bethlehem, you see the Muslim or the Christian, once you say Salam Alaikum, they will answer your Ma Alaikum Salam. That is just a language. So, on that one, Now, the third thing we are going to talk about, wait. Let's us vlog around first before I tell you the third thing. about Jesus. I'm going to tell you about Mary and Joseph now. That is not written in your Bible. I thought I was going to buy something here. I think make I go buy something for that fruit shop. I don't know which thing I go buy, sir. You see, these buildings are old school. They try to innovate them. You see, now old school houses, maybe say don't pay more than 300 years. Now you see so. So, you see. My house is what you say, don't pay, not be today. Not be today, not be today. You know? Not be today. So, this one now, Rasta shop. I've been waiting. Okay, let's move on. You're free if you're watching me from anywhere in the world. Ask me any question about Israel, I will tell you. The Christian in Israel is about 25 or 30%. Israel is not a Christian country. It's not a Christian country. It's not recognized as a Christian or Muslim country. They are Jewish. The Muslim is just about 10% or so. The rest are the Jewish. Oh. Let me buy a little of this. This is olive. When we are here about olive oil, olive. Now they take the olive and they make it in different. This one, a green one now. You see? And then they come make them different, different. I don't know which one will I go buy. And olive is very good.
Hi.
Yeah. I will buy. I think I should buy this one. Which one is not bitter? I don't want the one that is bitter.
This one is bitter, I see.
Yeah. See, okay. He knows. Give me the one is not bitter for 10 shekel, you know? Okay, no problem. I'm here. See? This one is cashew. All kind of food. See, different kind of rice they do here. Look at. We can show now different kind of rice we do. Now listen, I don't know this thing's name. I see rice. This one are rice. This one are rice. All this one are original rice per se. But this one I don't know. This one are rice. This one are rice. This one are rice. This black one too are rice. Now wow. That's only best in this. This one also not rice. Sorry, not the rice one. If you know what you do, you know. This one are coconut. All these things, they Niger now. All these things too, they Niger. See pepper. See, see granite.
Okay.
See granite. This one now, like a goosey. See, these people, they chop a goosey. You better see. They chop a goosey, but them, they know they take a cook. They chop them. Them, they chop them. Them, they chop them. They know they cook them like us. Understand? This one, the chopper. What's my feedback here? You see, all these things will be like a. You see, them, they know the chopper. I mean, they know they take and cook soup. See, you see, like this one now. Now, like a goosey, all these things now. If you buy them here, come take and cook. You see, I did not be a goosey with this one. You see, so as I talked before,
See granite. The one we get this thing. See, they still get the shade. You know, as I was saying,